الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا فصلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ Dear brothers and sisters, as you have found out through the ad that we are going to discuss what is hypocrisy today. Hypocrisy is known as nifaq or munafaqa in Arabic. And we must all know that in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, in the first five ayat, there's a description of the believers, of the God-fearing ones, muttaqeen, those who believe in the unseen, establish prayer and spend of what Allah Almighty has blessed them with. They have a firm belief in what was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and what was revealed before him. And they have a firm conviction about the hereafter. Such are the ones who are on the right path from their Lord, and such are the ones who are going to be successful. Then in two ayat, Allah Almighty has described about those who have not yet believed since the Quran has been revealed since the last 13-14 years. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَأَنذَرْتَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ It's all the same, whether you warn them or you don't. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ They're not going to believe. خَتَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ As now Allah has sealed their hearts, and so has He sealed their ears. وَلَا أَبْصَارِهِمْ غِشَاوَةٌ And there is a veil in front of their eyes that they can't see. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ And there is a big torment for them, a big punishment for them. Then the whole next session, starting from Ayah 8, all to Ayah 20, There's a description of hypocrites. Allah Almighty says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ And among people are those who say, we believe in Allah and in the hereafter. وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ They are not believers. Mostly, it has been taken as if they are just claiming that they believe. In fact, they don't. But if you carefully read this ayah, It clearly says that they believe just in Allah and in the hereafter. And they don't even mention that they believe in the Prophet too. On the other hand, in the beginning of this series, we found out the importance of believing in the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And I shared with you in express words that no matter how much one believes in Allah, in His oneness, in His greatness, and how much he has a conviction in the hereafter, but he doesn't enter the fold of Islam, he is never ever a believer unless he in express words believe that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Allah's messenger and his guidance is the last word of guidance. So here Allah Almighty is clearly mentioning that they believe in Allah and in the hereafter. So Allah Almighty says, وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. But they are not believers, as they don't believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. They try to deceive Allah and the believers. وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ. In fact, they don't deceive except themselves. فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. There is a problem. There is a sickness. There is a disease in their hearts. فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا. And Allah will advance them in their sickness. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And there would be a painful punishment for them. بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ. Because they used to have a false character. So the important word which I want you to pay attention to is fi qulubihim maradun. They have a sickness, they have a disease, they have a problem in their hearts. And each one of us knows that as far as the sickness, the disease is concerned, nobody ever wants to become sick. But he happens to become ill. He happens to become sick. He happens to have a problem in his body. So hypocrisy is a problem. It's a disease. Since no one would ever like to become a diseased person, no one would ever like to become sick of hypocrisy. We normally believe that a hypocrite is one who believes to deceive. He claims that he is a believer, but he is not a believer. In Surah Al Imran, Allah Almighty has mentioned a group of people whom the Jews prepared to believe in the morning and deny in the evening. And declared that yes, we went in and we have found out no truth in Islam. So we have come back. But my dear brothers and sisters, Allah Almighty does not call them munafiqeen, does not call them the hypocrites. They are deceivers, but not hypocrites. Hypocrisy, number one, is related to the belief in the Prophet. The hypocrites have a problem in believing in the messenger because he is a personified being standing right in front of them. His words cannot be interpreted. And if a wrong interpretation of his word is done, he is there to correct. He is there to say, I don't mean that. I mean this. To understand the real nature of hypocrisy, we must also keep in mind a living character of Abdullah bin Ubay, who was the chief of hypocrites at Medina.
Who was Abdullah bin Ubay? He was the richest man of Medina. Before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated to Medina, people of Medina had decided to make him their king, and there was a crown prepared for him, and thus he was to be coronated. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came without a crown, the people of Aus and Khazraj, the sons of the soil of Medina, who invited the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to migrate to Medina, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated to Medina, Abdullah bin Ubay wanted Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to stay at his house. When he entered Medina, he offered him his house, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam rejected his offer. From the very first day, Abdullah bin Ubay was jealous of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As he took his place, as I said, we must recognize that it's a disease. Number one, no one ever wants to become sick. No one ever wants to have a problem in his heart. But we all are caught by a disease. We happen to become ill. Number two, it's very important that you don't recognize a patient. You don't recognize a man suffering from a disease just by looking at it as they printed on his forehead that he is suffering from tuberculosis. He is suffering from asthma. He is suffering from flu. Or he is suffering from COVID-19. It's the signs and symptoms which tell you that you are having a problem or someone is having a problem. So these two things should be kept separate. Hypocrisy is something different, and signs of hypocrisy are something different. Sometimes the signs and symptoms overlap. For example, cough. It's a symptom. There are many problems in which you have cough. If you have a sore throat, you have a cough. If you have a flu, you have a cough. If you have asthma, you have a cough. If you are having whooping cough, yes, you are coughing then. If you have got a heart problem, then yes, you have a cough. Every cough is not whooping cough. Every cough is not a heart disease. You have to differentiate. You have to make a diagnosis. Similarly, fever is a sign. In many problems, you have fever. You have bad throat, you have severe fever. You have bad stomach, you can have fever. You have boil on your skin, you can have a fever. You can have a problem in your urinary tract or in an infection, you can have a fever. And if you are suffering from COVID-19, yes, you might suffer from a very high temperature. Every fever is not COVID-19. So, separate. Signs and symptoms are something different, and hypocrisy is something different. As far as the signs and symptoms of hypocrisy described in the Quran and in the Ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very kind. He used to describe things as they are being described as a subject. For example, he says, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ayatul munafiq salat. There are three signs of a hypocrite. And in another hadith, he says, arba'u man kunna fihi kana munafiqan khalisan. Four things when you find in a person, he is certainly for sure a munafiq. And if he have one of them, yes, he has one signs of nifaq, hypocrisy. These signs are, إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذِبَ, whenever he speaks, he lies. Whenever he makes a promise, he betrays. And whenever he is trusted, he betrays his trust. And whenever there is an argument, he starts abusing. These signs are of a typical situation, which I'll discuss with you later. But as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, it's the Kalam of Allah. It's Allah's word. And there can be no match of Allah's word. As we discussed in the first lesson of this series, guidance, Huda. Quran has a typical way of description. Since it's Allah's Kalam, Allah's word, there can be no match to this. Quran apparently describes the story, but there's a guidance in it. He gives the description of the hereafter. There's a guidance in it. There are direct commands. There's a guidance in it. Mostly, the Quran describes the signs of hypocrisy. In the description of different events in the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on which Abdullah bin Ubay passed certain comments. He, by his gestures, conveyed some message to his friends. I give you a few examples. At the Battle of Uhud, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam received information that an army of 3,000 warriors is coming from Makkah to attack Medina, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam called a meeting and discussed with them the issue and sought suggestions, proposals, how to combat. Coincidentally, the opinion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam coincided with the opinion of Abdullah ibn Ubay. Reasons must be different. And that was that we should fight from within. Perhaps Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam must have in his mind that we are small in number, so let men fight physically and women and children throw stone from above. But Abdullah ibn Ubay, he had a strong argument. He said, we are the sons of soil. We are the sons of the soil. We have a long standing experience that whenever we have fought from within, we have won. We have been victorious. And whenever we have gone out to fight, we have lost. But most of the Sahaba, especially those who could not participate in the Battle of Badr, they were telling Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we want Shahada. We should not stay at home like women. We should go out and offer our lives. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very kind. So he put even his own opinion aside and decided that we will go out and fight. Abdullah bin Ubay at that time passed a comment coming from outside, knowing nothing. No, this is a sign of hypocrisy. A believer who has an iman in his heart like a mustard seed, as tiny as mustard seed, he cannot assume even, think even, that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't know. But he said, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam left with 1,000 people, he called that, oh, we should not go for suicide, we are going back. And 300 people, it's not a small figure, 300 out of 1,000, that means About 30% left. Just imagine what these 300 people would be doing at home. I believe they were praying, "Oh Allah, let Muhammad face defeat. Let the Muslims face a failure, a defeat." And that actually happened. Although in the first instance, the Muslims won the war. The Prophet ﷺ appointed 50 people at the top of the hill. Archers. And gave them instruction that don't leave this place. Even though you see all of us are dead and birds are picking from our bodies. Even then, don't leave. When there was a victory, there was a difference of opinion at the top of the hill. 35 people out of 50. They said that the Prophet ﷺ asked us to stay if they lost. Since they have won and the war has come to an end, we must leave. But the commander said, "No, Allah's messenger meant that whatever is the situation, whether we won or we lose, don't leave this place." 35 people out of them, they said that you are just assuming that you are something, as Allah's messenger have made you Amir. We are going down. No sooner did they leave that place, Khalid ibn Walid radiallahu ta'ala anhu were looking, was focusing the point, and immediately he attacked with his cavalry, and the victory turned to a defeat. Now when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came back to Medina, Abdullah bin Ubay said, "Look, you didn't give importance to our opinion. Had you listened to us, we wouldn't have been lying dead there. So now, once for all, it should be decided that would Allah's messenger would do whatever he wants, or we also would be given a weightage in decision making. So that was the character of Abdullah bin Ubay. Now, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is also not there to correct us, to tell us, "I mean this." As Allah's word can be interpreted, so is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam can be interpreted too. Now, this situation will arise that if there is a Muslim caliphate again in power, Muslim khilafah, and there is a khalifa who, after consulting his team, makes a decision. Now it's the duty of all the Muslims to listen to him. Or there is an organization, Islamic organization, which is working for the cause of Islam. Again, all his comrades, all his companions, all those who have accepted him as their Amir have to listen to him. And anyone who doesn't accept him as his Amir from the core of his heart, he will actually prepare the ground to have the problem of hypocrisy in his heart. Similarly, in general, also Allah Almighty has described the signs of hypocrites. For example, in Surah Al-Ahzab, the battle of Ahzab, the battle of trench, the Quraysh attacked Medina with 10,000 warriors from all around the Arabian Peninsula, from different tribes. It was a huge number. Three sides of Medina were covered with mountains, and the palm date trees in huge number.
Only one side was open. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the consultation of Sahaba, was digging a trench to not let the kuffar, the non-believers, the Quraysh and their allies, to enter Medina. For 1 month, they were sitting outside Medina, but they could not enter Medina. Now the people of Medina, they were certainly in trouble. They themselves couldn't go out of Medina for their business, for their different activities, and not even for the calls of nature they couldn't go out. At this situation, the feelings of the hypocrites came out to be, مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. Oh, Allah and His Messenger deceived us. We were told that the Roman Empire and the Persian Empire would be under us, under our feet. But here, even Medina is getting out of our feet. In the same situation, the feelings of the Muslims, which was evident by their words, was Hadama wa'adana Allahu wa rasuluhu wa sadaqa Allahu wa rasuluhu. This is what Allah and His Messenger promised us. And Allah and His Messenger made a true promise with us. They were looking at Allah's promise in different ayat. For example, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. We would indeed test you to let you face fear, hunger, and the loss of lives and properties. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. And get good tidings to the enduring ones, to the steadfast ones. So yes, we would steadfast and we will get reward from Allah. Now, as I said, no one ever wants to become sick. No one ever wants to have a disease. But diseases do attack us. We are attacked by pandemics. We are attacked by different diseases. Very often we have sore throat. Very often we have bad stomach, etc., etc. But none of us wants to have a bad stomach or wants to have a sore throat, wants to be suffering from tuberculosis, etc., etc. But yes, we are hit by tuberculosis. We have heart attacks. We have renal failures. We have cancers. Now, all these problems we have, but none of us ever want to suffer from cancer. So, hypocrisy is a disease and we should be treated as a disease. Now, we move further. As I said, the basic problem which a hypocrite has, that he does not believe in Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the core of his heart. As I explained to you, Abdullah bin Ubay, the chief of hypocrites, he had a personal problem with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was personally jealous with him that he was to become the king of Medina, but Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam took over as not only the king, as the hero, as the beloved one of the people of Medina, though he didn't have a crown on his head. He didn't have a throne to sit on. He didn't have the clothes to wear to look like a king. Yet he was much more than a king. As the people of Medina, people from Aus and Khazraj, they accepted him as Allah's messenger from the core of their hearts. And they invited him to come to Medina. And they offered him all
what they needed. Shelter, yes, we are ready to provide you shelter. Food, yes, we would provide you food. We will comply with all your needs. So that was which could never be imagined, that anyone coming from outside can have this much offer. Now, since he was having a problem with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, at different occasions when Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked the Muslims to do something, and the Muslims out of the way complied with his command, he used to pass dirty comments. For example, he used to say, oh, don't give him extra lift. He's just a man like us. And if some true Muslim asked him, what nonsense have you said? What do you say? Oh, yeah, so your mentality is dirty. You have a wrong mentality. I don't mean that. I just pointed out that he is just a man. Don't worship him. The answer, the comment was passed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. When they are asked not to create a mischief on earth, not to undermine. قَالُوا إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُصْلِحُونَ. They said, oh no, no. We are actually fixing the problem. We are trying to reconcile. Allah innahum al-mufsiduna. Remember, note that it's they who are the mischief creators, who are the troublemakers. Walakin la yashurun. But they don't understand. You know, as far as Abdullah bin Ubay was concerned, he clearly understood what he was doing. But when such comments are made, some simple people, they are impressed by their argument. Oh, that's yes, it's important. So they are the ones who don't understand. I have mentioned the one basic problem with the hypocrites is that though they don't believe in Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But as far the word nifaq is concerned, its root word, letters are Noon, Fa and Qaf. And in Arabic, Nafaq is the tunnel which has two openings. Actually, Nifaq is basically try to have access to two sides. From you can enter tunnel from one and leave from the other. If you are inside a tunnel, you can go this way, you can go that way. Hypocrites actually, when they come across Islam, it appeals to them. Oh yes, Allah created us. Okay, we believe in Him. Oh yes, there should be discipline in the life. And the best way to bring discipline to the life is to call for accountability. Yes, there should be an accountability. And of course, the arguments which Allah's Messenger is giving regarding the accountability are strong. Yes, we believe in the hereafter. But when they embraced Islam in a good faith, apparently appreciating that yes, everything is okay. But when they were demanded that you have to spend in Allah's cause, since Allah gave you all that you have, spend all of it in His cause too, and not only your properties, your time, and even your life should be spent in Allah's cause. That was not acceptable to them. They believed in the hereafter. So, they thought, yes, they should have paradise. They should enter paradise. They should enjoy in the paradise. But for that, they were not ready to pay any price. The price was sacrifice. If you are ready to lose here in Allah's cause, Yes, Allah will bless you with much more in the hereafter. But they wanted to have and avail in the hereafter without losing anything in this life. So that was the problem. So the next ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah is, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ. And when they are asked to believe like others have, قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُ كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَاءُ, they say, should we believe like the nonsense ones, like these foolish people who have lost all their senses after believing in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr, who has donated all his property? He has no sense. My tongue hesitates to say, but I am quoting their words. Oh, he is nonsense. Umar gave half of his property. Oh, he doesn't have sense. We are sensible people. We go with calculation. We calculate that this is the need of our house. This is the need of my offsprings. This is the need of my business. I have to keep my business running. I have to take care of my family. So I am calculative. These are nonsense people. MaazAllah. The response from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was, Ala innahum humus safa. Beware. Remember. These are the nonsense ones. These are foolish. Walakin la ya'lamun. But they have no idea. The subject of nifaq, the disease of nifaq, has been mentioned many times in the Quran. But a complete surah on this subject is Suratul Munafiqun, surah number 63, which falls after Suratul Jumu'ah and before Suratul Taghabun. Allah Almighty says, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Idha ja'aka al-munafiquna qalu nashhadu innaka la rasulullah. When hypocrites come to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they say, Nashadu innaka la rasulullah. We bear witness that you are Allah's messenger, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wallahu ya'lamu innaka la rasulullah. Allah very well knows that you are His messenger. But one witness Allah Almighty also gives, Wallahu yashadu innal munafiqina lakadibun. Indeed, hypocrites are lying. The word they are uttering from their mouth is true, that Muhammad is Allah's messenger. But since they don't believe this in their heart, so they are lying. Although the statement is 100% true. اِتَّخَذُوا اِمَانَهُمْ جُنَّةً. They treat their iman as a protecting shield. فَسَدُّوا عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Thereby, they stop people from Allah, coming to Allah. Are they himself pause from coming to Allah? إِنَّهُمْ سَا مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Indeed, all what they are doing is wrong, is bad. Now it's very important. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا ثُمَّ كَفَرُوا. As I said in the beginning, that we assume that all the hypocrites, they join Islam to deceive, while they don't have any faith in their heart. But this ayah is telling that they believe, then they become non-believers. That I said, they in good faith join the fold of Islam, but when the demands come that you have to make a sacrifice of your property, sacrifice of your family, sacrifice of your business, sacrifice of your life, then they drag their feet back. تو ذلك بأنهم آمنوا ثم كفروا فتوب على قلوبهم. Thus their hearts were sealed. فَهُمْ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ. So they would not understand. Especially Abdullah ibn Ubay, who was the richest man of Medina, and he had his following. So whenever you are the leader of a community, leader of an organization, you are the head of state of a country, chief executive of a country, the person who create problems for you, they have their followings. They are the leaders of their party. You very well understand that they are wrongdoers. They are transgressors. They are atrocious people. But you are helpless. You not only listen to them, but you certainly think that they may not create a trouble for you. Allah Almighty tells Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when you look at them, you get impressed with their status. When yaqulu tasma li qawlihim, and if they speak, you listen to their words. Ka annahum, don't worry. They are just dry wood. You know, a tree, when it is in the soil and growing, living, it's not easy to remove from the soil. But when you cut away its trunk and then you try to make it stand on the earth, it cannot stand. You have to make it rest on the wall because it has no footing of its own. So these hypocrites also don't have their footings. But apparently they look very impressive, but in fact they are nothing. يَحْسَبُونَ كُلَّ صَيْحَةٍ عَلَيْهِمْ. Whenever Muslims are asked to gather in the mosque, as new revelation has come, they are always fearful that maybe there's an ayah against us which is going to expose our activities. Humul aduwwu, they are the enemies. Fadharhum, so beware of them. Qatalahum Allahu, Allah will kill them. Allah will fight against them. Anna yufakun, where they are running away. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا. Since hypocrisy is an offense against Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so the hypocrites of his time were asked to come to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to come to Allah's messenger and confess, this we have done against you, please forgive us. يَسْتَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ رَسُولَكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, so that Allah Almighty makes istighfar for you, asks Allah to forgive them. To forgive you. Love of Rusahum, they just shake their head, nod their head. Varaitahum Yasuddun. And you see that they hesitate to come. Stop. Vahum Mustakbirun. And they are very rebellious, arrogant. That why should we go to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Why should we go to Allah's Messenger and apologize? We won't do that. Because they don't believe that Muhammad is Allah's messenger. If they believe, they would certainly do. They are saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. But as far as their hearts are concerned, their hearts deny. Prophet ﷺ was very kind. Even short of this, Allah Almighty used to ask Allah to forgive them. Now Allah Almighty tells Rasulullah sahab, sawaun alayhim, astaghfarta lahum am lam tastaghfir lahum. It's all the same for them. Whether you ask Allah to forgive them or you don't. Lan yaghfir Allahu lahum. Allah will never forgive them. Inna Allah la yahdi al-qawm al-fasiqeen. Indeed, Allah doesn't guide the wrongdoers, the disobedient ones. Humul ladhina yaquluna. In military mission, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was coming back to Medina, and on way to Medina, at a place where they stopped, there was a dispute between a muhajir an immigrant and an Ansari, the local resident of Medina. Abdullah ibn Ubay was there. He said to the Ansari, the helper, you have been very kind to them, these immigrants, and you provided everything to them. You divided your houses, you divided your properties, and showed a very good gesture to them. See what they are doing with you. And then in Arabic he said, Sammin kalbak yakuluk, feed your dog and make it fat. Finally he will bite you. Allah Almighty responds, هُمُ الَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ لَا تُنْفِقُوا عَلَىٰ مَنْ عِنْدَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Don't spend any more on those who are with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, حَتَّى يَنْفَضُوا, until they themselves leave. وَلِلَّهِ خَزَائِنُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, and all the treasures of heavens and the earth belong to Allah. وَلَكِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ, but the hypocrites don't understand. Not only this, he further said, Yaquluna, they say, Lai raja'na ila al-Madina, indeed when we'll go back to Medina, La yukhrijanna al-a'azzu min al-adhal, the dominant one, the respectable one, will throw the detestable one out of Medina. Allah Almighty responds, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ, all the respect, all the domination belongs to Allah and His Messenger, وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and the believers, وَلَكِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, but the hypocrites don't know. I promise that the signs that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam have described of hypocrisy, I'll tell you later. When Islam demands sacrifice, you have to give time to the cause of Islam. You have to spend your property, your wealth in the cause of Islam. You have to give your time. You have to leave your houses. You have to leave your family for the cause of Islam. Now those who are suffering from the problem of hypocrisy, they would avoid. To start with, they would lie. Oh, sorry, I forgot. Then, next time, they would swear, by God, I forgot. Now, his trust will be gone. And he will say, oh, I really love to join you in that mission, in that journey, in that battle. But I totally forgot. Or I had this problem, I had that problem. And if at that time someone reminds him, how do you say that you forgot? We met at such and such place and I told you that I am going there. Was it not a reminder for you? How do you say you forgot? Now he will start accusing him, you are this, you are that. That is khasama fajara. Whenever there is an argument, he starts abusing. He just burst out. The last three ayat of Suratul Munafiqun, they are to treat hypocrisy. Now when you read the signs and symptoms, you look into yourself, you find that, oh yes, I have many signs of hypocrisy. The Prophet ﷺ said once, about hypocrisy, ma khafahu illa al-mu'min. It's only a believer who would always fear hypocrisy, that he may not suffer from this problem. While the hypocrite himself, who doesn't have a faith, who doesn't have an iman, who doesn't have a belief, he has no fear. As if someone who has been looted by the dacoits, by the thieves, and he has nothing with him, he can sleep deep because he doesn't have anything which can be stolen. But the one who has a property, one who has a wealth, one who has money in his pocket, and he is traveling, he would always be careful that his pocket is not picked. Anything doesn't become stolen from him. A believer would always be careful about his belief. Allah Almighty is telling. You know, when I was studying in dentistry, different diseases were described in the book. First of all, definition. Then signs and symptoms. And then treatment was discussed. And in the treatment, sometimes the precautions were also discussed. The hygiene was also discussed. Prevention. How can you prevent from this disease? So first of all, in the first ayah, Allah Almighty is telling us the prevention. And the prevention is, Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu, la tulhikum amwalukum wa la auladukum an dhikrillah. O believers, don't let your properties and your children, your sons, keep you away from Allah's zikr, from remembering Allah. The Prophet ﷺ said that Satan always keeps his mouth on the heart of a Muslim. If it is filled with Allah's zikr, with Allah's remembrance, Satan cannot harm him. But when he is ignorant of Allah's zikr, he forgets Allah's remembrance, he immediately blows into his heart. So Allah Almighty is telling, don't let your properties and your sons, your children, make you become ignorant of Allah's zikr. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. And those who do so, that become ignorant of Allah's zikr, Allah's remembrance, they are the losers. This was the prevention. If you fill your heart with Allah's zikr, Satan can not harm you. Hypocrisy cannot settle in your heart. But if you feel that yes, there is a problem, there are signs and symptoms, I seem to have attacked by the problem of hypocrisy, then what should you do? وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Since the problem came into your heart, you avoided sacrifice. Make a sacrifice now. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Your belief tells you that all you have is Allah's, not yours. He blessed you with this body, life, all the capabilities in this body. It was Allah's blessing. Nothing belonged to you. And your properties also were Allah's grace. Blessings of Allah. So, anfiqu, spend of them. In Allah's cause, min qabli ayyati ahadakum al-maut. Before any one of you has a time of death. Death appears to any one of you, and then he says, Rabbi laula akhartani ila ajalin qareeb. Oh my Lord, why don't you give me a respite for a near future, so that as-saddaqa, I do charity, wa akum min as-salihin, and I become of the righteous ones, salihin. Allah Almighty concludes, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. And Allah will never postpone for any individual the death when the time of his death approaches. وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. And all what you do is in Allah's knowledge. It can also be translated like this, that even if an opportunity is given to you, a respite is given to you, Allah knows what would your performance be. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He keeps our hearts clean, pure of hypocrisy. Allah Almighty washes away all the symptoms, gives us cure from all the signs of hypocrisy. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Quran al-Azim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikril hakim. رسول